Amid talks of Gaza truce deal, Biden and Netanyahu face immense heat from protesters. Israelis in Tel Aviv call for release of hostages in Gaza. Protests continue in U.S. campuses where pro-Palestinian and Israeli supporters clash. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken says he is hopeful Hamas would accept an extraordinarily generous offer to halt Israel's Gaza offensive in return for the release of hostages. U.S. President Biden holds separate calls with leaders from Qatar and Egypt over Gaza ceasefire talks, discusses the dangers of a military escalation. Four U.S. law enforcement officials were killed and five others injured in a shootout as they were serving a warrant at a home in the state of North Carolina. Debris from a missile that landed in the Ukrainian city of Kharkiv on the 2nd of January was from a North Korean Hwasong 11 series ballistic missile. United Nations sanctions monitors tell a Security Council committee. Janata Dal Secular Critical Core Committee meet today to decide on Indian lawmaker Prajwal Ravana's suspension from the party 2 days after a sexual harassment case was registered against him. At least 25 people dead and over a dozen injured after a bus plunges into a ravine from a mountain road in northern Peru. Pakistan's central bank maintains its interest rate at a record high of 22%. This decision comes as loan discussions with the IMF begin next month.